Hello, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Today we're talking about the brand new plugin, M-Backdrop Loop. M-Backdrop Loop is a set of titles and effects that can be used for green screen work, music videos, lyric videos, a lot of really cool, interesting things you could do with it, and we're about to show it to you right now in Final Cut Pro. All right, let's do this.
Once you've installed M-Backdrop Loop via M-Installer, it can be located in your titles, as well as your effects. M-Backdrop Loop is a pack of incredible backdrops. They're again found in your titles, 80 to be exact, and these are really interesting just because of the way that they work. Now, the way that these work are, once you can grab them, let's go ahead and just apply one really quickly, and we can see that we have that title layer. Now, what's really cool is when you drag these out, obviously it's in the title, they loop, so your animation speed stays the same and they just seamlessly loop. So when you're changing the duration, it is not adjusting the speed of these, and this is really, really helpful for a multitude of reasons. Now, because of the way that these are built, you'll notice up in our inspector, let's just go ahead, we'll click on it, and let's go ahead and just show you that we do, as always, have on-screen controls for position, scale, rotation, as are with most of the motion VFX titles and backgrounds. But over in our inspector, you'll notice something is a little different. We do not have animation in and out. This is something that typically is going to come in a pack of backdrops like this, but because these are looping, there is no animation in and out. This is why we have these set up as effects in M-Backdrop Loop. And then you can see we have animation in and out, and we have several of those, 10 to be exact. So if you want to apply these, you click and just drag on, and boom, you're done. And now when you see we hit play, it has that animation in. Now, if you want to make changes to those animations, you now go over into your inspector, into your effects, and here's your animation in and out. Okay, and then you have your mask scale and speed, stuff like that. And of course, they're all going to be different. So we can delete that one. Let's go back to the beginning so you can see that it's already on the screen. Let's just grab a different one. Why don't we just grab animation in and out number one? You can see that it disappears, and just kind of move forward here so that you can see. Now we have that really cool animation in and out. And again, it's over there in our effects. So just wanted to go over that really quickly. And now why don't we just take a look at a few of these since we already have number 7 loaded in. Let's go back over to our title. Again, we have on-screen controls. As we said, you can make changes to the center, scale, and rotation here if you'd like. You can adjust the twirls. So if you want the shapes to be a little bit different there, you can do so here. You can change the strength. You can add distortion if you would like. So you can see that kind of waving around. That's really kind of cool looking. I'm going to go ahead and hit play so you can see what's going on there. Really, really neat. Continuing down, we have our glow that we can toggle on and off. Cell source. Now, the cell source is going to be how many of these little things are happening. So the bigger and fatter they are, the smoother that animation's gonna look. Your opacity. And then cell clone blur and amount. And then we continue down and we have a replicator position. Now this is going to kind of be the position, but I want you to notice something. It does appear as though it's kind of in that three-dimensional space. So you see that? And then we could use our on-screen controls to just move that over. So if we wanted it to have this kind of crazy look there, like this three-dimensional look, check that out. And then we can toggle our background on and off. Why don't we delete that? Let's go back over to our titles and let's find another one. Now, if you want to preview any of these, just simply take your mouse cursor and drag over, and you can see the different types of backdrops. This one is really cool. I'm going to show you this one, and it includes a drop zone. So again, on-screen controls for position, scale, and rotation. You have your animation, rotation, and bounce, and speed. So let me go ahead and apply something to this drop zone here. Obviously, this is to look sort of like a record. So we're just going to click our drop zone well, add in our cover for Timeline of Forever, a really fun song. Go look it up. Let's use our on-screen controls to just kind of bring that down so it looks like the disc. Notice the top right there is kind of cut off. That's because our scale needs to be increased a little bit so we can fill that circular radius. I'm going to kind of move me over a bit. And then why don't we just change some of this text here. So we're just going to change this to Timeline of Forever. Now I want to increase the size so it just kind of creeps around. You can notice there in the center there. We can just call this the Tutorials, because that was the name of our little band that we created. Yeah, and that's really about it. We could make changes to our text here if we wanted, but I think all of that works. You can toggle on your circle there in the center, as well as make changes to the radius and such. We can make changes to our color. So honestly, I think black looks kind of cool. It fits with our theme, so I'm going to just leave that. Toggle on our lines. Make our lines a little thicker if we wanted, just to really illustrate that we're going for kind of some vinyl there. Show how many rows we want of lines. You can drag that up there if you want to increase that. Grunges. So as we hit play, you can see kind of that grungy look is happening all over the screen there as we're kind of bouncing around. Now you'll notice that that's happening, of course, all over the black section there, right? That is because that is also intended if you had something beneath. So why don't I just drag the Timeline of Forever screenshot beneath just so you can kind of see what's going on there. And you can kind of see how that looks, how it's kind of an overlay over top of that. So some glitching, some little crazy things happening. It's really cool. We could use our on-screen control if we wanted to kind of just push that over, bring it over to the side there. Let's just say that we were kind of promoting it. We could put some blur on our background there if we wanted. So why don't we just add some Gaussian blur there, and we could just add a little bit of text if we wanted. Control T, doing this really quickly. We'll just find some random fun font there. We can boom, Timeline of Forever, Out Now. Change their face really quick to some kind of yellow or something. It's a little too orange. Boom, and there you go. And now you can kind of promote that. It's happening. We got Timeline of Forever. And why don't we add, let's bring our text down beneath. So now it's being kind of affected there. Boom, Timeline of Forever, Out Now. We can promote it. We can just have it looping however we want. Lots of fun. This one's really crazy looking. Check this out. So you can just add in whatever text you want. So why don't we just go over to our inspector. You can change this in the center to just say like MV effects maybe. Awesome. Something like that. Motion VFX is awesome. Now, something to note about these on-screen controls, you are not going to be able to move the position of this just because of the way that it's built. So these are only for rotation, and then this is actually going to affect the center of our sphere there and how that looks, okay? If you needed to change the position, you would just want to use your transform, and then you'll be able to use your position as you need. Again, these are seriously cool. There's 80 of these that you can play around with. Have a blast. We can't wait to see what you come up with. using MBackdrop Loop in your videos. Again, this is George Edmondson from MotionVFX.com. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.